Hello students, welcome to Web Technologies online classes. Today I am going to explain about the concept of HTML forms. Till now we have discussed about the HTML tags. If you want to represent any textual information on the web page, some predefined HTML tags we can use. But what is the use of HTML forms right now? So in this session we will discuss each and everything step by step. In this session we have to learn. Okay, now let us start our session. Okay. I'm opening material that is in my pen drive and GP Odyssey 2021 syllabus Web Technologies, and this is our notes, Technologies notes. What is HTML form? Explain about the form attributes. What is HTML form? Explain about the form attributes. So actually, what is the form? An HTML form is a section of a document which contains controls such as text fields, password fields, checkboxes, radio buttons, submit button menus, etc. So all those things we have to integrate in that HTML form. So all of you carefully observe. Now I am opening one window in the browser, then you can understand what is the use of form. Okay, for that I need to connect internet connection to my laptop through my mobile phone. Okay, the mobile data and mobile hotspot. Okay, net connection is connected to my laptop. Now I am opening Chrome window. So Facebook I am opening because of all people regularly it is using, no? So that's why Facebook I am opening. In the Facebook window, username and password fields are there, no? Username and password field and login button. So all those things we have, no? Create new account, forget password, all those things, these all are integrated into a form. First of all, we have to know about the concept of what is the use of form. So till now we have discussed about the plain text tags. We have discussed in the previous classes, like heading tags, paragraph tags, all those things we have defined, and all those things we have discussed in the earlier classes. But now we have to discuss about the forms. So all of you carefully observe. For your understanding purpose, I am opening one notepad window. Here my requirement is simply I can develop a plain document. I don't want to send this data to a server. So that's why plain tags are NF. Plain tags means the root element is HTML opening tag and HTML closing tag. And before that, now I need to give the intimation to the browser. Now I am using the HTML5 information, HTML5 version. So that's why doc type is mandatory. Before, one exclamatory mark is also must and should be required. Then only syntactically it is right. And doc type HTML lowercase I am here typing. So if you write like this, we are giving the intimation to the browser. This is related to HTML5 version. whatever the tags we are using, that all are related to HTML5 version. So then only browser can understand, browser can execute all those things. Okay. So the root element is HTML is the root element. In between these two tags, we have to write our information. So remaining tags I'm using head tag. Head tag is also very important to declare the title, to declare the web page title. So in between these two tags, title tag, we need to configure. Title tag we need to configure. All of you carefully observe. Before I'm going to explain about the forms concept, the plain text uses I'm explaining right now. Once again, I'm explaining. So then only you can understand about the forms concept. Plain text. And body. In between these two body tags, we have to configure one H1 tag. Heading I'm choosing. I want to display the heading as also. What is this? Usmania University. Okay. Usmania University. Now I am saving this one. OU.html. Save as type is all files. Save as type is all files. All HTML files we need to give the extension of .html. Here name is Ivovish, and after that .html is mandatory for every HTML program. Understand? Now I am clicking on the save button. Now it is saved in practice problems. This file is available in my pen drive. So don't think about the location, about the saving file. So if you want to save on the desktop, then you can choose the desktop location. Okay. Or if you want to save any other drives, then that is your wish. You can choose your location. OU file is available here. Then I am double clicking on the file for executing purpose. All of you carefully observe. Usmania University. It is a plain text. Only displaying purpose I am using. The heading. Here my requirement is I want to display a heading. So for that, just simply I can use the, directly I can use the H1 tag. After that, I want to represent on the web page as a paragraph, some paragraph, some information. This is educational university. This is educational university. Just simply I can type the one paragraph, that's it. Don't think about all those things. In this university, number of courses available. Okay. Available. So now I am closing the paragraph tag. So now I am saving. Go to file menu. Choose save option. So okay. It is saved. Now I am executing. Already the file is open. Just refresh button you can click. Automatically that paragraph tag is also will display on the screen. Display in, this is educational university. In this university, number of courses available. So this is my requirement. I want to show these two plain text. So that's why plain text use it directly. H1 tag is used directly and paragraph tag is used directly. So now what is the use of forms? Sometimes I want to send this information to the server. I want to send this information to the server. Server means, for example, for your understanding purpose, I am giving one more example for you. I am telling, what is that? For example, bus pass. For example, if you want to apply any bus pass, for that one online application you need to fill. So that is one of the form used by the form. I mean, whatever the information displayed that that tags, that complete information integrated into the form. I think you haven't understand right now also. And here I already open one Facebook information. All of you carefully observe here. Now I am opening Facebook window. In this is username window, this is password window, this is login button. Why these all are integrated into your forms? All of you carefully observe. Now if you want to see this source code, just right click on the text box, inspect option is there now. You click on that, automatically that code will display. And this is the original code and this is the supported code. So if you want to see this complete information is integrated in the form or not, you can check. Just simply you can move on the up position, div tag input. Okay, here observe form tag they are used now. They use the form tag. Why form tag user? Now I am closing this one. So if you give the username and password and click on login button, first this username and password will send to the server, because of that particular person is Facebook user or not, it will check. If the person is Facebook user, the validation completion, the person is find out by the server, then internal page it will display. The login will successful. I mean that page, that your account will open now. So like that, form is very useful for this purpose only. If you want to send any information to the server, first we need to give the username and after that we need to give the password. After that we need to click on the login button. When you click on the login button, automatically this complete information, nothing but that username and password, will send to the server. After that, that server functionality is what? Server task is what? Whatever the username and password received by the server, internally it can check in the database. The username is available in our database or not. If the user is find out, I mean if the user is a Facebook user, it can find out. Then it immediately, if the user is related to Facebook, then automatically that Facebook page it can open. I mean that account will unlock by the that username and password. That then only that page will display on the screen. Am I correct or not? So here what is the use of form functionality? It is sending to the information to the server. So if you want to send any information to the server, form is very useful. So that is the introduction part of form. If you don't want to send any information, just simply you can use the HTML tags. It will display on the screen. But if you want to send any information to the server, compulsory in between form tags, you need to configure these text boxes and labels and login buttons. All those things we can configure in that. We can write that code, related code, into the in between form tags, opening tag and closing tag. Understand? Now we have to see the practical. Then only you can understand what is the use of form. Okay, now the introduction part has completed right now. So now I am closing this one also. Again, one more window I am opening. On my notepad window I am opening. So what is the syntax of form? First of all, doc type tag is also must and should be required, and for that one exclamatory mark is also must and should be required. HTML5 information I am giving to the browser, then only HTML5 tags will work properly by the browser. The root element is HTML tag. After that, HTML closing tag is also must and should be required. Next, head tag. Opening and closing tag, in between header tag, title tag I'm using, HTML forms, that title I'm giving. Okay, title tag is also I'm closing. So this is common to for each and every HTML file. Now body space we are giving. In the body tag, whatever the form we have to define. So in between these two tags, we have to give that information. So first of all, I am giving the heading. For that H1 tag, I am using login page. Login page. Okay. This is also I need to align. Sorry, left alignment is over. Just for your understanding purpose. And after that, form tag I am writing. Form opening and closing. Form opening and closing. Form opening and closing. This is the syntax of form tag. Here, form elements we can use. Okay. So up to here, the syntax. Up to here, the syntax we can use. So in between these two tags, form opening and form closing, form elements we can use, like text boxes, login buttons, all those things we can configure in between these two tags only. Okay. Okay. The syntax is over right now. Real time example I am showing right now. Now I am removing form elements instead of this one. Real time example I am giving. Okay. Label tag I am using. Label opening and label close. Label close. Here label is nothing but what? Label is nothing but what? For your understanding purpose, I am opening gmail.com. Okay. Here also your login credentials required. So here create account option is there. Actually this is called button. But plain button applying. So all those things can you read here. English, United Kingdom, help, privacy, terms, sign in, Google image, continue to Gmail, all those things, plain text it is displaying. This plain text is displaying in the labels format actually. It is in the labels format. So now we can see the practically, for your understanding purpose, username, this is one label. Okay. After that, input window also I am giving. Input type equal to text. In between double quotes, I am giving this information. So everything I will explain clearly. Don't worry. First, you need to concentrate on forms. In between forms, this, all those things we need to configure. Then only we will get some output. Then after getting output, you will get an awareness on this. Okay. So input type is text. Now I am closing this one. After that, one more label. Closing password. Okay. So password. And for that password also, one input required. Password also we need to give. So that's why type equal to in between double quotes password directly we need to configure. So value is must and should be password. So the password has the predefined functionality. You don't need to change this one. Okay, compulsory you need to use that fixed values, type equal to text. If you want to give any plain text, all of you carefully observe here. Facebook window open now. So in this username place, plain text we want to enter. So for that, this is the text button. The value is text, input type equal to text we need to use. But here the password is not required to show to others na. So that's why here password we need to use. So password has the different functionality, because of whatever the values we entered, that value it will be hide by the password value. Understand? Right. Now after that, login button is also must and should be required. For that, one more input required, type equal to login, sorry, submit is the button here, and the value is directly, the value is displaying on the button, so that's why login I'm giving. So each and everything it will display on the screen, just simply you can understand. And BR tag required. BR means break the line, otherwise it will, all those things it will display on the side by side. Understand? Side by side it will display. So that's why I'm giving like this. Okay, now I am saving this one, forms.html. save as type is all files. Now I am clicking on save button. Okay, now I am opening save location. So web technologies practice problems, in that forms is our file name. All of you carefully observe. Oh, all are displaying in the same font na, because of heading tag I haven't closed it right now, so that's why it is waiting for closing. Here just simply you can use the slash. If you want to close any tag, then simply you can use the slash window. Now again I want to refresh. So all of you carefully observe, this is h1 tag. After that, form tag open and form closing tag is also open. In between, this is label, username is displaying in the label format, and this is input text. Here my username is Siva, okay, and password is 123456. 123456. Password is displaying or not displaying, because of the value is password. If you want to display a plain text, so here input type is equal to text we need to use. After that, login, just click on login button. And now here I'm not connecting any other page, any other web page to go. When you click on login button, it will go for that. Okay, so that's why it is not going to any way. Okay, if you click on login button, it is not going to any way. Understand? So for that, in the form tag, action tag is must and shouldly required. When you click on login button, one more page it need to open na? So that's why. So in action attribute is must and shouldly required. This is form attribute. When you click on login button here I want to give submit button. Siva username is I want to give, and password is also 123456. Just simply understand. Okay, after that I need to click on login button. So if you click on login button, it is not going to anywhere because of code has not completed. So that's why here one more attribute I'm using, action attribute. If you configure action attribute, one more notepad I need to open. In this, your account is successfully login. Thank you. So these two messages I want to display. For that, I'm saving this one. success.html all files. Save as type is all files. Now I am saving on the click button. Sorry, now I am clicking on the save button. So this as it is file name, succes.html. So that as it is file name, in between double quotes, we need to configure in the action attribute. Understand? So action attribute functionality is what? When you click on login button, whatever the file you have configured in this action button, that file will display on the screen. Understand? That file will display on the screen. Now I am saving this one. Now I am saving this file. Again, I am refreshing this one. Again, I am refreshing this one. Now I am giving the credentials. Siva is the username. Password is 123456. Okay, just click on login button. So what it is displaying? Student details. Sorry. Already. Okay. Wait. Already that file is available in my location. Previously I have practiced it for your understanding purpose. So that's why success is there na. Okay, this file I am removing. Wait. Already two files available. The previous file it is displaying. That's it. Now I am removing this one. So succes. The file name is succes. 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 Okay. Now refresh. Siva is the login name. 123456 is the password. Okay. Student details successfully submitted. What is this? What file I have deleted? Okay, I'm opening this one. Okay. Actually, original file I deleted. Now I am removing this one. And this window. I am saving this one. Okay. It is saved. succes. The file name is succes. So once you remove, I am saving. Now I am executing this file. Okay, whatever the file you have configured, that file will execute when you click on login button. Okay, Siva 123456 is the password. Login. Your account is successfully login. Thank you is also displaying side by side. Because of here, I am not using any break window. Sorry, I am not using any break tag, BR tag. Now it will display two lines. Understand? So this is the use of forms. HTML forms. If you want to send any information to the server, for that purpose we can use the HTML forms. So HTML forms contains how many attributes? Name is one attribute, action is one attribute, and method is one attribute. Okay, target is one attribute. Here four attributes we have. The name attribute you use it to give the name of the name to the form. For example, sometimes if you want to work with some other softwares, if you want to send the information to the server directly, that programming language is also receiving these attributes information. So for that, which form it is coming? Now I am assigning the name to the form. This is login form. So name attribute is used to declare the form name, define the form name. Form name purpose, name attributes you can use. So when you click on login button, this information first it will send to the programming language. In between any programming language you can use now. So first you need to understand one diagram, then only you can understand forms information. So here this is browser window. This is browser window. While executing time, one more box I am drawing for the form. This is form. You just assume this is login form. Okay. This is browser window. Browser. This is our file. Login form. Dot HTML file. Okay, I write. Next, this is programming language. This is completely called MVC architecture. This is database. So this is programming language. Like C, C++, Java, PHP, anything. Okay, anything they have to use it. Any programming language, that is software company requirement. But I am giving the information to the, architecture of project first of all. And this is database. This is database. Like Oracle, Sybase, MySQL or SQL Server. So these all are databases. But in this, any database they can use. And here also in this, any programming language, any one programming language they have to use in the projects. Okay. So at server side, these two technologies available at server side. These two technologies is available at server side only. This is called as server. And this is called as client. Understand? Client means you are the client. You are logging in your laptop na, at your home. So that is client. If you have the internet connection, when you use the, when you open the Facebook, when you give the username and password, immediately you need to click on login button na, sign in button you need to click. After that, the complete user information and password information will send to the server first. Server, it will receive. After that, inside server, whatever the technologies we have, programming language is there. So programming language, first it will receive. After that, that programming language will send to the database. Database functionality is what? That username and password is available or not, it will check. It is available. Arrow marks is also must and should be required. Then only you can understand the execution flow of your program. So this is also going. Our client to server. The data is flowing, the data is going. How it is showing. So first the username and password we need to give. After that we need to click the login button. And when you click on a login button, the browser will send to the, that information to the server. And server internally it contains programming language and database. Any one programming language they can be used internally. And that programming language received by the, that credentials, whatever the username and password you have to send, that information first it will receive. After that, the programming language will send to the database. So these two username and password is available in our database or not. Whether that user is our Facebook user or not, it will check. That it is find out after that it is searching part is completion. Immediately, if the user is find out by the database, then it will send to the programming language. That person is our Facebook user. So they need to give the permission. We have to give the permission to access his account. Understand? So immediately programming language is also will send to the browser. So that account will open like that. So this entire process is called in the project development. This entire process is called MVC architecture. MVC architecture. MVC architecture. Actually, in the C language, explained time is also in the previous semester. Means in the second semester, I have explained MVC architecture concept. Now also I can explain it same thing. How the project is going behind. First, this part. After that, server will receive all those things. So internally, server content, programming languages and database, all other extra technologies also they have used it. No problem. Okay. So like that, the data is flowing like this. So here, all of you carefully observe. If you give the name attribute here with the name, the programming language can detect. So this is the data comes with this login form name. Login form. The data is coming from login form. So programming language can understand. So for that we need to give the name attribute. Name attribute is used to define the form title. That information is giving to the server. Server handling all those things with the name information only. Okay, with the help of name, it can understand. After that, action attribute is also must and should be required for each and every form. So already I told you why action attributes we need to use. Action attribute functionality is what? When you click on login button, immediately it will send to the here success .html. HTML page I have configured here. So when you click on this button, automatically, all of you carefully observe. Here I configured success.html form. So the username is Shiva. The password is 123456. After that, I am clicking the login button. It is going to some other document now. So for that purpose, if you want to communicate one document to another document, action attribute must and should be required. When you click on the login button in our form, automatically, whatever the file you have configured along with action attribute, that file it will display after logging, okay, after clicking on the logging button. So one document to another document it will jump now. So that's why. Next, method attribute is also must and should be required. All of you carefully observe here. After name attribute, method attribute I'm using here. Form is the element. Inside form opening tag, we are using the some attributes and values na. So these are called attributes. Action is also one of the attribute. Name is also one of the attribute. And method is also one of the attribute. In between double quotes, whatever the values we have configured, those are values. Okay, those are values. So all of you carefully observe method. Here method values are two values we have. Get to post. Either get or post we need to use. Any one we can use. So what is the use of this one? If you send a small information, small size of information, get attribute, get value is enough. Get value is enough. But it is not providing any security for us. So if you configure method equal to get, so all of you carefully observe. Now I am saving this one. Again, one more time I am displaying. What is the problem with the get? So if you want to send any information to the server, here username and password 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So now I am clicking login button. all of you carefully observe this here. It is displaying na here all details. I mean the data string it is displaying na. Wait. Method equal to get. So instead of get, now I am using post value. Wait. First we have to see the get. If you want to send any small information, get is enough. But it is not providing any security for us. Okay. Now I am refreshing this one. Okay, right. The username is Siva. Password is 123456. Now I am clicking logging button. Here it is displaying this one. The user, I mean web technologies, practice, problems. Okay, all the file location it is displaying directly. So it is not providing any security for us. Instead of that one, I need to display post attribute, post value. Again, I am saving this one. Again, opening this one. I am going to back this file and refreshing this button. And it has refreshed. And Siva, the password is 123456. Right. It is also same string displaying. There is no difference now. But get is not providing any security, but post is providing the security. I think we need to execute one more file. For that, I am opening one more notepad window. HTML opening and HTML closing. And form tag I am opening directly. Closing form tag is also must and should be required. And okay, username equal to input type equal to text. Password input type equal to password. Input type equal to submit value equal to submit. Okay. User.html I am saving with that name. Save as type is all files. Now I am executing that file. Okay, wait. Here I haven't configured anything. In the form, method equal to get. Method equal to get I am using. Now I am closing this one. Now I am opening user file. Okay. Here username is Siva. Password is 123456. Now I am giving the submit button. Okay. Same URL it is displaying. But okay, I think in HTML4 here in this browser address bar, the username and password is also displayed here. The username and password display in the string format. So there is no, that is not providing any security by the get value with the method attribute. But if you use the post attribute, it will provide the security. But it is coming to HTML5 version. Here it is the get value is used for a small quantity of data sending to the server. For that purpose, we can use the get value with the method attribute. But if you use the post attribute, it is providing the security also, and also some some large information it is provide, it is sending to the server. For that purpose POST is very useful. Understand? Okay, so these all are attributes, and one more attribute we have, target attribute. If you use the target attribute in our form, here the values, here the values are what? Underscore blank, underscore self, underscore parent, underscore parent. If you use the underscore blank, let us see. The value is underscore blank close. Okay, so now I am executing that window. What is that form? Forms. So if you use the blank underscore target equal to underscore blank, now I am giving the credentials, 123456 is the password, and I am clicking the login button. So all of you carefully observe, this window is same, it is showing now, but one more window it is opening. Underscore blank is nothing but it is whatever the target file if you want to open along with forms, that target file is open in the new window, in the new browser window. If you click on login button, one more window it will open. All of you carefully observe, one more window it is opening now. So that is the use of underscore blank. And one more thing is there, underscore parent. Parent is nothing but same window it will display. By default the value is parent window. Okay, by default the value is parent window. Now I am closing these two success windows. Now I am clicking on this button. Sorry, now I want to refresh this one. And this file is also I want to save, otherwise previous functionality will open. Okay, now I am going to do the refresh here, and Siva is the username, 123456 is the password, and login button. So same window it is opening now. So that is the functionality of the underscore parent. The value of underscore parent is working in same window. The value of underscore blank working in, I mean, it will open in some other extra window, it will open one more new window, it will open. Understand? And next, self is also same like a parent. It will work. Self means own window it can use to open target file. Now I am saving this one. Now I am refreshing that one, and Siva is the username, 123456 is the password, login. Same window it is opening now. So like this, three values it can support, underscore self, underscore parent, work like a similar values, similar functionality, these two values it has. And underscore blank is a new window it will open. And next, encrypt. Encrypt means sometimes if you want to provide any security for your data to sending information to the server, if you want to send information by using any security, I mean in between, nobody cannot see if you use the encrypt attribute. So for that encrypt attribute we need to use. Encrypt attribute contain two values, URL len coded. So URL len coded. So if you use this one, it is used to only for picture images. If you want to send any information for the picture images by the providing any security by the encrypt attribute, this value you need to use. Encrypt equal to this value you need to use. Or if you want to send any plain data or any large string data, if you want to send only text information, for that the second value, multipart/form-data, we need to use. So that is the functionality of form attributes. So how many attributes we have? Name attributes, name attribute, action attribute, method attribute, target attribute. Here four attributes related to form for the form purpose we can use these four attributes. These are common for form attributes. Okay, form element. So actual functionality is what form. If you want to provide, if you want to send any data to the server, compulsory form element we need to use, form tag we need to use. In between opening and closing form tags, we need to configure text boxes, labels, buttons, radio buttons, checkboxes, all those things we have to configure. So along with form tag, some four attributes it can support for the form. These four are related to form attributes. The first attribute is name attributes. Second attribute is action attribute. Third attribute is method attribute. Fourth attribute is target attribute. Understand? So these all are useful, and this is an important concept for the HTML. So all of you should carefully listen. If you haven't understand, then again one more time you have to listen. Then second time is also you cannot understand. If you have any, if you don't understand, then call me. I will explain clearly. Okay. Thank you. Today I am going to ending this session, and in the next session we will discuss about the form elements. Form elements. Form elements are nothing but radio buttons, text boxes, text area buttons, all those things I will explain clearly. Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed this session.